aerosol in the atmosphere. Have you noticed how the smoke from fire itches your throat, or how snow beside a highway turns black? Smoke and other air pollutants contain small particulates that have an effect on our health, as well as on the temperature of the planet. Only recently have we started to better understand the effects of these small particulates in greater detail. So, what are these particulates? Particulates are solid or fluid particles that are found in the atmosphere and that have a maximum diameter of a few micrometers. Throughout time, particulates have been formed, for instance, by wind blowing dust into the air, plants releasing pollen, or a volcano erupting. Also, trees in the forest produce gases, such as isoprene, which derive particulates. Over the oceans, particulates are formed by plankton, producing dimethyl sulfide. In addition, humans produce particulates, for instance through burning processes, construction work, and burning tires. The smallest particulates are from gases that are in the atmosphere. For instance, sulfur and nitrogen oxides from pollution form particulates. Particulates affect both health and climate. Let's first take a closer look at the effects on climate. Particulates have both a warming and cooling effect on the climate. The warming effect is caused by dark particulates absorbing heat energy. For instance, coal particulates in the air or on top of snow absorb heat energy, causing the air to heat up or the snow to melt. Particulates also have a cooling effect on the climate, because they reflect sunlight back into space. In addition, they cause the formation of clouds, which again reflect sunlight back into space before it reaches Earth's surface. So, how do particulates form clouds? The formation of clouds always needs a particle, or a nucleus, around which the cloud starts to form. When the air is moist, water vapor condenses around a nucleus and forms a water droplet. These droplets form a cloud and can fall down as rain when they increase in size. So, how do particulates affect health? The most health issues are caused by the nanoscale particulates, as they are small enough to travel from our lungs to other organs through blood circulation. They can then cause damage, from heart diseases to breathing problems. Such nanoscale particles are found especially in smoke from cigarettes and fire. In some cases, filters can be used to prevent particulates from spreading. These are especially effective in the chimneys of factories. However, preventing particulates from spreading due to forest fires and soil cultivation is practically impossible. As particulates do not spread evenly around the atmosphere, the problems they cause are often regional. Especially big cities may be surrounded by smog containing different types of chemical particles, such as small black coal particles. However, particulates can also travel thousands of kilometers before ending up in the lungs of a person. In Europe, particulate emissions are controlled through the development of technology and politics. Therefore, in developing countries, the consequences of particulates is much more severe than in Europe. Nonetheless, even in Europe, particulates in outdoor air are considered to cause 400,000 premature deaths each year. Also, the economic consequences of the health issues caused by particulates are hundreds of billions of euros each year. So, what can I do to reduce my particulate emissions? 1. Find a way to make an impact in your everyday life. For instance, you can choose to commute rather than driving your own car. 2. Find out how clouds are formed and how different nuclei have an effect on the formation of clouds. Find out which types of particulates work especially well as a nuclei in the formation of clouds. Especially scientists from Finland have done groundbreaking work on how particulates are formed from gases produced in forests, so you may want to look into their findings. 3. Examine the differences between different regions. Examine maps on how concentrated particulates are in Antarctica, in a desert, far away from cities, in a middle-sized town, and a polluted megacity. Together, we can make our world a better place to live in.